Good morning students, this is 12th class biology, lecture 5 of chapter principles of inheritance and variation, and at the end of lecture, we will also discuss the homework solutions of lecture 4. Now, let's start today's lecture. And the topics that we will cover today are dihybrid cross and law of independent assortment. So, let's start with the dihybrid cross first. So, dihybrid cross is a cross between two individuals that are both heterozygous for two different traits. Okay, so it is cross between the individual, those are heterozygous for two different traits, right? And Mendel studied inheritance of two genes by dihybrid cross. By monohybrid crosses, Mendel studied inheritance of one gene, and here Mendel studied inheritance of two genes. Let's try to understand inheritance of two genes with the help of this dihybrid cross. So here Mendel took two types of seeds. Okay, he took into account two characters at one time. And what were those characters? Shape of seed and color of seed. Okay, so he took yellow colored round shaped seeds. Okay, and second seeds, green colored and wrinkled shaped seeds, okay, for crossing. Now, in monohybrid crosses, Mendel knew that yellow color was dominant over green color, okay, and round shape was dominant over wrinkled shape, okay. So, here capital Y is representing yellow color, okay, and small y is representing green color. Likewise, capital R is representing round shape and small r is representing wrinkled shape. Okay, so Mendel crossed these two seeds. Okay, and in F1 generation, what was the phenotype of the plants? All the plants were having yellow colored seeds with round shape. Okay, so this result was exactly equal the is exactly similar the result of monohybrid crosses. In monohybrid crosses also, when yellow and green colored seeds were crossed, at that time also, in F1 generation, only yellow colored seeds appeared. And when round shaped and wrinkled shaped seeds were crossed, then only round shape seeds appeared. Right? So, the result was similar to the monohybrid cross. And here, what would be the genotype of F1 plant? Because of the crossing of these two, there will be combination. One small y with one capital Y and one small r with one capital R. Okay. So, after inbreeding of these F1 plants, there will be formation of F2 generation. Right. So, here these F1 plants will make four types of gametes. So, these are four types of gametes made by male pea plants, and these are gametes from female plant. Right. After crossing, or you can say after fusion of these gametes, these are the results in F2 generation. In F2 generation, you can see here there are four phenotypes are here. Okay, some seeds are round yellow, some are wrinkled yellow, some seeds are round green, and some are wrinkled green. Right. So, you can count the number from here. Now, these four phenotypes, we need to know the phenotypic ratio for these four phenotypes, right? Okay. So, we will count this. How many round yellow seeds are present here? So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So, 9 round yellow seeds are present here. And what is the genotype for these round yellow seeds? Because, you know, that capital Y is responsible for the yellow color of seed and capital R is responsible for the round shape of seed. So, for the round yellow phenotype, at least one of the allele, one out of the two allele must be capital Y for the yellow color, okay? And for the round shape, out of the two alleles, one must be capital R, right? So, here you can see the genotypes. Here one capital Y is present, here one capital R is present, that's why seed is round yellow. Here also capital R is present as well as capital Y is present. That's why seed is round yellow. Okay, so in all these combinations, seed will be round yellow. Okay, so there are total 9 round yellow seeds. Then second phenotype that we talked about, that was wrinkled yellow seeds. Okay, and these are wrinkled yellow seeds. 1, 2 and 3. 3 are wrinkled yellow seeds. And you know, wrinkled shape is recessive to round shape. So here, for the wrinkled shape, what condition is necessary? That small r should be present in homozygous condition, right? Only then shape can be wrinkled. Okay, and color of these seeds is yellow. Okay, so at least one y will be in capital state. Okay, so here you can see for these three seeds, small r in homozygous condition but one capital Y, that's why phenotype is yellow wrinkled, right? Here also capital Y is present, but this small r is present in homozygous condition, that's why this is also wrinkled yellow. Here also small r is present in homozygous condition and capital Y is present, that's why this is also wrinkled yellow. So here one trait is dominant and another is recessive, right? Now third phenotype that Mendel observed was green colored round seeds. Okay, so here green color is, you know, recessive to yellow color, that's why small y should be present in homozygous condition for the green color. Okay, so you can see in these three seeds small y is present in recessive condition. Okay, and for the round shape at least one capital R should be present. So here in these three seeds you can say one capital R is present at least. Okay, so these three are round green. Okay, so what is the ratio for the yellow round R? 9. Then yellow wrinkled R? 3. Then green round R? 3. And last phenotype that Mendel observed was wrinkled green. And this is only one seed that is of wrinkled green type, in which all the recessive alleles are present for both the characters. Okay, so small y and small r, these are present in homozygous condition and these are recessive alleles for both the characters, means for the seed shape as well as for the seed color, right? So what is the phenotypic ratio in dihybrid cross of Mendel? This is round yellow seeds were 9, round green seeds were 3, wrinkled yellow seeds were 3, and wrinkled green seed was only 1. So phenotypic ratio in the cross was 9:3:3:1. And here this ratio, 9:3:3:1, is exactly equal to the ratio of monohybrid cross ratio in F2 generation years. How? Because in F2 generation, what was the phenotypic ratio? Just recall it in your mind. It was 3:1, right? So it was for one character only. 3:1. It was for one character, right? It was 3:1 for one character, right? And this is 9:3:3:1 for two characters. So if we multiply 3:1 by 3:1, because here we are taking into account two characters, okay, so what will be the result? It will be 9:3:3:1, right? Here you multiply it with it, so 9:3:3:1. It will be the result. So you can say that in dihybrid crosses also Mendel observed the same phenotypic ratio as he observed in case of monohybrid crosses. Here also what was the ratio of round shape and wrinkled shape? Here you tell me, what is the ratio of round shape and wrinkled shape? This is, you can say, 12:4. Okay, round shape, how many seeds having round shape? Total 12 seeds. Okay, and how many seeds have wrinkled shape? Total 4 seeds. Okay, so this is 12:4, you can say, for the seed shape. Okay, 12:4 can be written as 3:1. Okay, and in monohybrid growth also phenotypic ratio was 3:1. Now look at the color of seed. Okay, now how many seeds are of yellow color? So 9, these 9 are of yellow color, and these 3 are of yellow color, so total 12. And how many are of green color? That is 3 and 1. Okay, so for it also it will be 12:4. Okay, or you can say 3:1. So for both means the dominant allele is expressing itself in 3 times and recessive allele 1 time. Okay, so it will be 3:1. Now look at the genotypic ratio. Here you can see that there are how many different genotypes are present here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So 9 genotypes are present here. And what is the ratio of these 9 genotypes here in the dihybrid cross of Mendel? Look here. So what genotype that is that you can see here is both the capital R and both capital Y. So how many these combinations are present here in this complete cross? Only one, right? Only this is present here, so we can write for it 1. Okay, then next combination you can see here, this is both capital R and capital Y small y. So how many are present? 2. So you can write 2 for it. Okay, so 1:2. Then look at next one, this is capital R small r and both capital Y. Then how many this combination is present? 2. Okay, so you can write 2 for it. So if you will look at these combinations, then you will find a ratio 1:2:2:1:4:2:2:1:1. Okay, and this ratio is the genotypic ratio of dihybrid cross. You can simply write it like it will be easy to remember, to keep remember it. 1:2:1:2:4:2. Okay, 1:2:1. Like it will be simplified, no? 1:1:2:4:2:1:1, like this. Okay, that's up to you how you want to remember it. Next topic is law of independent assortment. Law of independent assortment means that at the time of gamete formation, okay, by meiosis division, at the time of gamete formation, the two genes segregate independently. Consider if there are two genes for two different characters, then these two genes will segregate, means will separate independent of each other, okay, as well as of other traits. This law also states that at the time of gamete and zygote formation, the genes are independently passed on from the parents to the offspring. You can understand law of independent assortment with this dihybrid cross. Here you can see this dihybrid cross is given between yellow and round seeds and wrinkled and green seeds. Okay, so look here. In after F1 generation, when gametes are formed, okay, so here gametes are receiving the alleles independently, or you can say here in the parents, what is the combination? This is capital Y is always present with capital R and small y is present with small r, right? This is the parental combination. But here in the gametes, you can see capital Y can be present with small r as well as small y can be present with capital R. Okay, so you can say these two genes for two different character, means gene Y and R, these two genes are independent to each other at the time of segregation, or you can say at the time of gamete formation, these segregate independently. Okay, capital Y is not dependent on capital R always, and small y is not dependent on small r as well, on R always, okay, and vice versa. So here four types of gametes will be formed. How? Because in F1 generation, you can see the combination, okay. So at the time of gamete formation, for this character, if you look, for the Y gene, means it for color of the seed, okay. So for the color of seed, there is two alleles are present here. One is capital Y and another is small y. So at the time of gamete formation, both have equal chance. So you can say 50% chance to go into the gametes. So 50% gametes will receive the capital Y and 50% gametes will receive the small y. Now, a gene for this character, means for the seed shape, will also get segregate, okay, at the time of gamete formation. Now, segregation of these alleles, means capital R and small r, is independent of segregation of these, okay, and these will have also 50% chances to go into the gametes, okay. So now the 50% gametes which are formed having this capital Y and this small y will have equal chances to get either capital R or small r. So this is the law of independent assortment, okay. Here you can see that in the parents only one combination was present. Always the capital R is present with capital Y and small y is present with small r. But here in the F2 generation, you can see that there are so many different combinations are also present. Okay, and these combinations are capital Y is present with small r as well. Okay. And small y is present with capital R as well. Okay, so the genes R and Y are independent to each other at the time of gamete formation. Now, next thing we have, calculation of types of gametes formed. Now, in dihybrid cross, because here Mendel took into account two characters at a time. Or you can see in F1 generation, the plant was heterozygous for two loci. Okay, for two loci, we can say for the two positions of chromosome, there were different presence of different alleles. Okay, so how can we calculate the types of gametes which will be formed? Okay, so it is calculated by formula 2n, 2 ki power n. What is n here? N is the number of heterozygous position of gene. So, for example, if any organism is heterozygous at three loci, okay, so here you can see this is one gene, this is second gene, and this is third gene, okay, pairs of genes are present here. So there are two alleles of gene A, these are two alleles of gene B, and these are two alleles of gene C. Okay, so at all the three position, different alleles are present. Okay, so we can say this organism is heterozygous for three loci. Okay, so what will be the value of n? It will be 3, because it is heterozygous at three loci, first loci, second loci, and third loci. Okay, so n will be 3, and that's why types of gametes which will be formed will be 2 ki power 3, we can write, and we can expand it like this, 2 into 2 into 2, and the result will be 8. So in this case, 8 types of gametes will be formed. Here this is the cross that we took into dihybrid cross also. Okay, so here you can see the organism is heterozygous at 2 loci, first loci and second loci. This is heterozygous for 2 loci. So what will be the n? 2. And what will be the types of gametes which will be formed? 2 into 2 is equal to 4. So 4 types of gametes will be formed here. So you sign the dihybrid cross, how many types of gametes were forming? 4 types. Now, based on today's topics, your homework is NCERT question 3 and 7. And yes, students, one more thing, you need to read NCERT. Okay, so read all these topics from NCERT book also.
Let's discuss the homework solutions of lecture 4.
So first question was, explain codominance with example. So answer of the question is, codominance is the phenomena in which both the alleles of a contrasting character are expressed in heterozygous condition. Okay, so if the two alleles are present in one organism, you can say that heterozygous condition. Both the alleles of a gene are equally dominant, means both will express themselves, right? Now we need to explain it with help of an example. So here is the example. ABO blood group in human beings is an example of codominance. Here in the ABO blood group, character is controlled by three sets of allele, and name of those alleles are IA, IB and small I. These alleles IA, IB are equally dominant and said to be codominant as they express themselves in AB blood group. Next question was NCERT question number, no sorry, this was an extra question. Question number 2, genes responsible for seed shape in pea plant shows complete as well as incomplete dominance. How? So here you can see that this is the phenotype. The same gene is responsible for the seed shape as well as starch grain size. Okay, so that gene for seed shape, how it's affecting the phenotype? So due to presence of allele capital R in homozygous condition, seed shape will be round. Okay, and when it is present in heterozygous condition, or you can say capital R is present with small r, then also seed shape is round. Okay, so in this case we can say that capital R is dominant over small r. Okay, so this is showing complete dominance, right? But the same gene is controlling starch grain size also. Okay, and in that case you can see here, in case when the capital R is present in homozygous condition, starch grain size is large. Okay, and when capital R is present with a small r, in that condition capital R is not completely dominating small r. That's why in this case it is showing incomplete dominance, right? Next question is, question number 3 was, what is pleiotropy, and tell some example in human being with the trait affected by it. Okay, so a common example of pleiotropy in human is disease phenylketonuria. Okay, and in phenylketonuria what happened? Enzyme which is responsible for converting phenylalanine into tyrosine is not formed, right? And what are the other diseases which are caused due to this phenylketonuria only because of one gene? These are mental retardation, reduced hair and skin pigmentation, and also eczema. Eczema is rashes on skin.